Welcome to How It Works, a video series from LawSites and LawNext in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from their developers. In today's episode, we're taking a look at Leap legal software and more specifically, new AI features it recently integrated into the software platform. Joining me today to tell us about these new AI features and show us how they work is Andrew Kundin, Director of Pre-Sales. Andrew, welcome to How It Works.
I'm Bob. Thank you for having me. Pleasure to be here.
Well, before we get more into the demo, why don't you give us a little bit of background on what you've launched here?
Sure. So my name's Andrew. I'm an attorney. I used to practice in the UK, came to the US. I've been working with Leap now for about 6 years. We've launched three AI product offerings, and I'm going to share my screen and show you a little bit about them. We're going to be talking about Leap and how we're leading the future of legal AI. We're going to be showing you a product called LawY, but I quickly want to talk about Leap and generally the new tools that we've released. So Leap has built a number of premium AI tools. All these tools have been purpose-built to meet the unique needs of law firms. The idea behind all of them is that firms can focus on more high-value work and avoid basic repetitive tasks, allowing you to serve your clients. Generally, the tools are broken down into three main pillars. So the first one is asking questions. That is what LawY will do. You can prompt it with legal questions that you have, submit them for verification, and then you can know with peace of mind that the answer has been verified by an attorney. The second tool is based around drafting. It's called Generator. It allows you to use firm correspondence and other documents in the database to create court templates, letters, emails, so on and so forth. And the last tool is based around analyzing. It's called Matter AI. And what it does is it allows you to process all the information that's available in the Leap system and cross-compare documents, extract specific pieces of information, and summarize documents. Generally, these tools are not aimed to replace lawyers. They're just aiming to eliminate repetitive tasks. All of them are purpose-built. Most of them are around specific jurisdiction and area of law. And it just gives you more time to focus on growing your practice.
Great.
So the tool that we're going to be demoing and talking about today is called LawY. LawY is your trusted legal AI assistant. The way it works is you simply ask questions and you receive quickly tailored answers. It helps you conduct legal research, draft letters and documents, prepare court documents, and proofread, check your grammar, and summarize documents. LawY, it looks at different sources, and it uses our knowledge base to then improve the answers that are provided. LawY is integrated into Leap and is available from within your matter. It knows which state and area of law you're working in, and it will provide tailored answers specifically to that state and area of law. So before we jump into the demo, I quickly want to talk about how LawY is built. So LawY is built on a large language model system. It uses OpenAPI and GPT-4 to source its answers from. Now, you're probably thinking, what sets LawY apart from ChatGPT? Well, number one, our LLM is designed specifically to answer legal questions. It's been built that way. ChatGPT will usually provide you with more federal and national law, as within the answer, it'll be typically federal or national law, and the answers will not be tailored. LawY will also source the relevant statute or case law as a resource to support its answer. And as you verify the answers with attorneys, those answers are then submitted back to the knowledge base, and that is what LawY will use to answer future questions. This is also the mechanism that it uses to learn from itself and improve future answers. And then, yeah, that's really it. You ask it a question, and then it provides you an answer, and you can choose to verify that answer with an attorney.
Great. Well, is this a good time to jump in and show us how it works at this point?
Yeah, absolutely. So, first things first, I'm going to launch Leap. So, for those of you that don't know, this is the first screen that you see in Leap. This is your dashboard from where you will navigate to a matter. For today, I've chosen an estate planning matter in Massachusetts, and we're going to be using this Richardson matter here. When I click on it, it opens up a matter. This is what a Leap matter looks like. So, on the left, you have your pre-configured fields, and on the right is where all your correspondence lives. You'll notice that LawY has been integrated into the toolbar. To launch it, you press on this little AI legal assistant button up here. This will launch the LawY interface. So What you're looking at now are all the different prompts that have been asked in LawY specifically for this matter. You can choose to click into one of them, for example, this one here, and you can just read what the previous question was and what LawY gave as an answer. If you click on the Matters tab, it'll just show you a summary of all the different questions that have been asked across the entire database. From here, you can navigate specifically to one matter and then see the prompts in there. Do you have any questions?
Yeah, well, I mean, can you, I mean, you may get into this, but what are examples of the kinds of prompts you'd want to be asking of this?
It's a great question. So you can ask LawY pretty much anything. Since considering we're on an estate planning matter, you can ask, for example, how can two people serve as co or joint healthcare proxies? You can ask, what are the differences between per stripes or per capita? You could ask it questions about irrevocable trusts, who's legally responsible to pay income tax, how to process monetary cash gifts, pretty much anything relating to estate planning. Would you like to see how to ask it a question and what it can do?
Yeah, let's move on to the next part of it.
Perfect. So to ask LawY a question, all you would do is you would press the Ask Question button up here. From here, a little window will pop open and you will type in a prompt. So I'm going to ask, can two people Then I click Start Conversation, and that's how I start the conversation with AI. Takes a second to render the answer. From here, you can already see that the answer is specific to Massachusetts. It knows that I'm in an estate planning matter, so that's why it's giving me an answer that is tailored to estate planning. Here's the answer to my question. It says that no, Massachusetts does not allow for two people to serve as co or joint healthcare proxies. And the reason for that is because it's sourcing that information from the general laws. Now, this references part is super cool. What it allows you to do is once it's provided you an answer, you can then click on the link and it'll take you to the resource, whether it's a statute or relevant case law, and show you that's why it sourced this answer.
Are you able to say where it's getting the case law and those other resources?
Yeah, you can click on the resource and it'll open up.
Takes you right to the Massachusetts general laws.
Exactly. So moving forward, I just want to quickly talk about some of the use cases and other functionality around LawY. So number one, once you have an answer, you can easily copy it to a clipboard. And then from there, you can paste it into an email, another document that you're working on. There's also writing tools available within LawY. These things allow you to do what you kind of see with other AI tools. You can change the tone from professional, casual, straightforward, confident, or friendly. You can remove PII, which stands for personally identifiable information. So if you asked a question that was very specific to Gary Richardson, which is the matter that we're currently in, you can choose to remove any information relating to him. You can summarize the answer, or you can choose to translate it into a number of different languages. Awesome. Well, the next thing I want to show you is I want to have a more in-depth conversation with AI. So to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to press ask a question. And this time we're going to ask it, what is the estate tax threshold? And then from there, I can ask it a follow-up question. And it will provide an answer explaining how a request of lien in Massachusetts is filed. Now, you'll notice in the answer that it's provided that over here, it's asking to provide required documentation. And the additional documents are here. But if I wanted a full list of them, what I could do is I could prompt it to provide me a checklist. And here you can see that AI has provided me with a full list of supporting documentation that I need for my leave.
That's great. You know, I know you've been talking about estate planning law in Massachusetts here, and you made reference earlier to the fact that answers are provided according to the state and area of law in which the lawyer is working. How many areas of law or how many states are covered at this point, and what are plans for expanding this to beyond those current areas?
For sure. So at the moment, LawY is operational in Massachusetts in estate planning, probate, and divorce. It's operational in New Jersey in the same three jurisdictions, so estate planning, probate, and divorce. And in New York, it's working for divorce. The plans are to continue expanding it across pretty much all states and all jurisdictions. We've chosen these three because that is primarily where the majority of our client base is concentrated. Massachusetts, New York, and New Jersey are historically where LEAP started, and that's, again, where a lot of our clients are. But I think you'll see Florida added very soon, as well as other states.
Yeah, I'm in Massachusetts, and I know LEAP is, has been here for a number of years.
Yep. The other reason for that is, and that kind of is my next point in the presentation, is when you get an answer in LawY, you can submit it for verification. That answer will then go to an attorney that has 5 or more years of experience in that state and in that area of law. And that kind of links back to your question about what the expansion plan is. So as we hire more attorneys that can verify answers, you will see LawY expanded into more areas and more states.
Yeah. I think the verification thing is great. I mean, obviously, one of the concerns that a lot of lawyers have with using any generative AI tools is that it might be hallucinating or making up an answer. And that ability to get a human verification of an answer seems to be really a unique feature in this product that I haven't seen with other products out there.
Exactly. I mean, I think the verification feature is great. It's really trying to blend what AI can do for you in terms of creating drafts and just eliminating those repetitive tasks that you do. But if you're not sure of something, or if you're not, maybe you don't know the answer at all, you can just ask LawY to do it for you and then get an answer from AI that is then checked by a human.
And if I submit that, if I click on that button to submit for verification, what happens?
The request will just go off to an attorney. We are paying them their hourly rate, so it is in their best interest to verify this pretty much as quickly and as accurately as possible.
And any guidelines as to how quickly a customer might expect to get a response?
It depends. It depends, A, on the complexity of the question. If the question has been previously verified by the system, it'll pretty much spit out a verified answer almost instantly.
Great.
And yeah, that's pretty much it. It's pretty simple. You ask a question, you get a tailored answer, and then the answer can be verified by an attorney.
And if I am a LEAP user and I am in one of the states for which this feature is available, what do I need to do to make it? Do I have to activate it in any way? Is it an add-on product? How do I get access to this?
It's included with the LEAP system. If you're a LEAP client, you'll have access to LawY. That's pretty much the same for most of our products. They're included within the LEAP package.
Well, that's great. I think that looks really great. Is there anything else that you wanted to tell us about it before we wrap up?
Yeah, just one last thing. So a couple of quick disclaimers. So the verification process is entirely anonymous. So you do not know who is verifying your work, and they do not know what law firm is requesting verification. It is designed to protect you that way. The other point I want to quickly touch on is on data control and user-centric precision. So LawY does not extract information from your legal matters, granting you complete authority over the information that you choose to share. While the use of personally identifiable information should be avoided, any inadvertent disclosure is safeguarded inside LawY, so there's substitution of placeholders in the verified answers to shield your law firm. Only verified answers are then subsequently included in LawY's knowledge base, ensuring that your sensitive data remains secure within your control. In short, if I was to include any information on Gary Richardson and it was in this answer, and then I submitted that for verification, LawY is smart enough to remove all his personal information so that does not get added to the knowledge base.
And is that removed before it's submitted to the outside attorney that's going to be doing the verification?
It is, yes.
Great. It's important.
Yeah. I mean, the outside attorney is just trying to review the law. The placeholders for where Gary's information would show up inside these answers would all be removed.
Anything else, Andrew, that you want to show us about
this?
No,
that's really it.
All right. Well, I think it looks really great, and I really appreciate your time today showing us this product, and congratulations on its launch.
Thank you. It was a pleasure being here.
Well, that's it for this episode of How It Works. You can find the full series at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab or on YouTube. This is Bob Ambrogi. Thanks for listening.